Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Line of Commerce. In this video, I'm going to explain you how you need to do past adjustments if closing capitals are given in the question. First thing is, we need to identify whether the capitals given in the question are closing capitals or is it opening capitals. How will you identify it? Now, if the capitals in the question are given after the adjustments of profit and drawings, then those capitals are closing capitals. So read the question carefully. They will say A, B and C are partners. Their capitals are this, this, this. These capitals are after making the adjustment of profits and drawings. Then those capitals are closing capitals. Or if they say A, B, C are partners, their capitals are this, 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 that's it. Then those are opening capitals. Now, if closing capitals are given in the question, then we need to first find the opening capitals to charge interest on capital. We need to find opening capitals, and on opening capitals, we need to find interest on capitals. So now, without wasting any time, let us understand the concept with a numerical question. I'm going to do question number 74. From your textbook, T.S. Gewal, this is the textbook, 2020 edition. The question is given on page number 2.90, question number 74. I'll just read out the question. I'll display the question also on the screen if you don't have the textbook. This is a board exam question also. So the question goes like this. On 31st March 2014, the balances in the capital accounts of Saroj, Mahinder and Uma, after making adjustments of profits and drawings, see, after making adjustments of profits and drawings, etc., were 80,000, 60,000 and 40,000 respectively. So these capitals of 80,000, 60,000 and 40,000 are after making the adjustments of profits and drawings. So definitely these are closing capitals. Okay, subsequently it was discovered that the interest on capital and drawings have been omitted. You have not provided interest on capital and interest on drawings. Now, the profits for the year ended 31st March 2014 was 80,000 rupees. During the year, now drawings information is given. During the year, Saroj and Mahinder each withdrew a sum of 24,000 in equal installments in the end of each month, and Umar withdrew 36,000. These are the total drawings actually given in the question. During the year, Saroj and Mahinder each withdrew 24,000. During the year, a sum of 24,000 they have withdrawn, and this 24,000, how they have withdrawn? At the end of each month. So you should know the average period to calculate the interest on drawings. So if you don't know, I have made videos on calculation of interest on drawings also. Please do watch those videos. I have given the link in the description. And I have, in one of the video, I have explained one tip or trick to remember the average time period. Please do watch that. Okay, let's go further. Next bit, it says the interest on drawings was charged at 5% per annum. So interest rate is 5% per annum for drawings, and interest on capital was to be allowed at 10% per annum. Interest on capital is 10% per annum. The profit sharing ratio among the partners was 4:3:1. So that's the profit sharing ratio. Show you're working clearly and pass the rectifying journal entry. So this is the question. Let's solve this. First, what we have to do is we need to find our opening capitals. And then on that opening capitals, we need to find the interest on capitals. So first, let us do that. Okay, let's find out the opening capitals and then we will find interest on the capitals. Okay, so I have made this format. The format is simple, particulars, the partners, Saroj, Mahinder and Uma. We can find the capitals together for all the three partners, and then we can find the interest on capital also. So how we need to do it? See, closing capitals are given in the question. Let us first take that. So closing capitals. So what are the closing capitals given in the question? It is 80,000 for Saroj, 60,000 for Mahinder, and 40,000 for Uma. So these are the closing capitals. Now next step, what we have to do is we need to add our drawings. Please remember, we are going back from closing capital, we are going and finding opening capital, we are going back to the opening capital. So drawings have to be added, please remember this. So I need to add the drawings. Add drawings made during the year. Made during the year. Okay, so drawings, 24,000 for Saroj, I need to add it. 24,000 for Mahinder, I need to add it. And the last partner, Uma, 36,000 is the drawings. So I added the drawings. Now my next step, what I have to do, see the question. It says there is a profit of 80,000 rupees. So profit share, we have to deduct. We need to deduct profit share. In case if it was a loss, we need to add it back. Now next step, I need to deduct profit share of each partner. Profit share. Now this profit share, 80,000 is the profit share. I need to divide that 80,000 in the profit sharing ratio, which is given 4:3:1. Simple, we can directly do it. So 40,000 for partner Saroj, 30,000 for Mahinder, and 10,000 will be the profit share for Uma. 4:3:1 is the profit sharing ratio. I'm just putting this in brackets so that I remember, so that you remember, you need to deduct this. Done. Now let us find what is the opening capital for each partner. Opening capitals. Okay, so the opening capital, 80,000 plus 24,000. So 80,000 plus 24,000 minus 40,000. So it's coming 64,000 for Saroj, the opening capital. Next, Mahinder, 60,000 plus 24,000 minus 30,000. 54,000 for Mahinder. And for Umar, 40,000 plus 36,000 minus 10,000. So it's coming 66,000 as opening capital for Umar. So we have calculated our opening capitals. Now let us find the interest on capital here itself. Interest on capitals. So interest rate, the interest rate, interest on capital was to be allowed at 10% per annum. So this will be 6,400 for Saroj, 5,400 for Mahinder, and Umar it will be 6,600. So our interest on capital is done. So this is how you need to find out opening capitals, and then you can find interest on capital on that opening capital. So please remember, identifying whether the closing capital is there in the question or is it opening capital, that is most important. Read the question carefully. If the question says so and so capitals are after making the adjustment of profit and drawings, then those capitals are closing capitals, and this is how you need to find out the opening capital. Add back the drawings, total drawings made during the year, and deduct the profit share. You will get your opening capitals, and then find interest on capital on that. Done. Hope you understood this. If you want to write it down, or you can take a screenshot. Now next step, we need to make our adjustment table to find out what will be our adjusting entry. Let's do that. So let us prepare our adjustment table. So first item what I'm going to put here is interest on capital. We have already calculated interest on capital here. So first item, interest on capital. Interest on capital. So 6,400 for Saroj credit, because Saroj will get that. Partner gets interest on capital. 5,400 for Mahinder, again it will be a credit for Mahinder. And 6,600 credit for Uma, because it is received by the partners. Now let us find out the total. 6,600 plus 5,400 plus 6,400. So that is 18,400. 18,400 give a debit to the firm. I am using calculator, you don't use it. Okay. Now next, interest on drawings. Interest on drawings. Now drawings, very interesting situation. 24,000 during the year, Saroj and Mahinder, they are withdrawing. So interest on drawings. Interest on drawings. Now for Saroj and for Mahinder, how will you calculate? So it will be 24,000 times interest on drawings. The rate is given at 5%. 5/100 times. At the end, it says at the end of each month. At the end of each month, it will be 5.5 divided by 12. If you don't know how this average time period is coming, please do watch my video. So these two zeros will get cancelled, and then 20 times. So the calculation will be 20 times. So it's coming 550 rupees, the interest for Saroj and Mahinder both. Now for Uma, he has withdrawn 36,000 during the year. It doesn't say how he is withdrawn, what is the whether it is per month or per year or per quarter, nothing it is given. So it will be 6/12. Okay, so if there is no information in the question how the drawings are made, the average time period will be 6 months. So 36,000 times 5% times 6 divided by 12, so it is coming 900 rupees for Uma. So these are the interest on drawings. So let us put that in the adjustment table. So 550 debit to the partner, 550 debit to the second partner also, and 900 debit to third partner. Okay, so this will be, it's coming 2000 rupees. 2000 rupees credit to the firm, because firm receives it. Now if you remember, next step, you need to find the difference. Difference of each column. So for Saroj, it will be 6400 minus 550. So it's coming 5850 credit for Saroj. For Mahinder, 5400 minus 550, it's coming 4850 again credit. And for Uma, 6600 minus 900, if I do, I'm getting 5700. This is also credit. And last column, firm's column, this is debit and this is credit. So this will be 16,400 debit. Now the balance what you get in the firm's column is your profit or loss. debit balance is loss, so we need to distribute that. So now loss will be distributed. Loss distributed. Okay, what's the ratio? 4:3:1. So we need to distribute this 16,400. 16,400 times. So it's coming 8,200 debit for first partner. $6,150 for the second partner, and it's coming $2,050 for the third partner Uma, and this will be 16,400. Just write credit because you have already distributed it. Now the last step where you will get your adjustment entry, that is net effect. So 5,850 minus 8,200. So it's coming 2,350 rupees debit it will be, because debit is more. And 4,850 minus 6,150. So 1,300. 1,300 again, this will be, if you see, debit is more. And the last partner, 5,700 minus 2,050. It's coming 3,650 credit, and this is nil. So we got the answer. So this is our adjusting entry. So we can pass the entry. I'm passing the entry without any format. When you pass your entry in the examination, you need to make the format of the journal entry. Okay, so the entry will be Saroj's capital account debit, Mahinder's capital account debit to Umar's capital account. So this will be 2,350, this will be 1,300, and this will be 3,650. Hope you understood this. Then write being adjustment entry passed. Done. Hope you understood the question. This is how you need to do it, and this is how you find your opening capital and interest on capital. I hope this was helpful. So hope you understood this. You can write it down or you can take a screenshot. Okay, so that's it in this video. Next video, I'm going to explain past adjustment with minimum guarantee. Please do watch it. So meet you in next video. Till then, take care. Goodbye.